supposed to be doing. Catch it like the sweet spot there. It's weird.
I don't like the look of what they're building.
Oh, geez. That guy's got a force field.
What?
I don't know how any of these new characters are. Why is he sneaking? He needs to run away. A. LT. Left trigger. Oh, it's like an auto-aim thing. That's interesting. What is this exclamation point off to the side? It's telling me to aim at. Probably can't do any damage to the guy behind the force field. I switch targets. This is interesting. I've never had this targeting system. Jeremy, what's up? Oh, and Victor. Hey guys. Huh? No, they're just in the chat room there to the side of the us playing. Huh? They're just watching us playing. They literally have nothing better to do. Tori said that's lame, guys. B. What is that? I don't even know what I'm doing. Can I get through that force field? Looks like they're just bouncing off. How do I get through that force field, Tori? It's weird. You gotta hold the left trigger down. Yeah, I wanna hold the right one down too for some reason.
Another transport incoming.
We don't have enough cover here.
Oh, thanks, Poe. Right? Aim and shoot at Lego targets to destroy the explosives. What'd you say, darling? I was supposed to be pumping B. It's weird. Why do they keep having me attack the guy behind the force field? What is going on? They don't expect us to shoot that big thing out of the sky with our little hand cannons, right? Oh, wait.
We gotta destroy that blaster turret.
X.
Shoot the fuel cell. Hit it where it hurts.
Okay, Poe. Hit him where it hurts. Oh, I can hit him. I thought I was joking, but I can actually shoot him up there. That's crazy. One little laser blaster. Take down a huge ship like that. Who'd have thought? I don't like this shooting aiming thing. Let me run around. Oh, get a shot. Opposite. Yeah, I'm using my left joystick to aim. I'm used to using my right joystick for other games. And I keep wanting to use my right shoulder button to shoot. That's not right. That's a Fallout thing. Okay. What'd you do? Whatever you did there, honey. Good job. Shoot the fuel cell, Andrew. Thank you, Victor.
I said don't move.
Is that the Phasma lady? Captain Phasma? Times three. Ooh, I have some sort of bonus going. True Jedi already. Baby's sleeping, Tori. Your exclamations. Yeah, True Jedi. That's an achievement. If anyone knows this series of games. Where'd you go, honey? Where are we going? Spoiler. Oh, let's blow this stuff up. Can you connect to this thing? Oh, that usually means that a bounty hunter can attach a bomb to it or something like that, right? Here, there's probably something I can shoot over here. I thought we came over here already, but stuff's still blown up now. Trapped over there, can't go that way. Oh, I like that new power move. Boom. I know, they don't want you to go that way. Why did they make it shiny? I want to hop up there and kill the stormtroopers. Can we access it back here? There's fire and fences. Oop, ouch. That burns. Oh, yeah, that's a cute bit of trivia. Did I double check to make sure that's true? But I think Bill Hader is credited as doing BB-8's voice in the credits for The Force Awakens. Ooh, I'm supposed to do B here. Okay, I'm pulling some tower down or something over here. We'll probably be able to build something with this stuff. What? Why isn't it letting me build it? There it goes. Yeah, this is a new feature, yeah. You want to put on a headset and talk, Tori? So that circular rectangle is your aiming. Yeah, that's a new aiming system, Victor. I've never seen that before in this game. And what Tori's doing right now, her little robot, that is also a new thing. They've added a bunch of new features and control mechanics to this new updated version of the game. But the original ones were forever ago now, weren't they? They were for like the GameCube. Like 15 years ago. There's a new, like, you see B flash up when I'm about to attack someone when I get close? That's a new melee attack system that they're introducing. Oh, see that flashing up here? If I hit B, I can toss my, oh. See, there's the melee attack. That's cool. Just kind of choke slammed him. the thing flashing up there, hit B, I'll toss my grappling hook. Then I pump B, I'll pull it down and make garbage out of everything. Then you build stuff out of the garbage. And BB-8. Yeah, that's usually how these puzzles work. And then BB-8 will be able to do it. See, what do we got, Poe? He's got a cute laser blaster here. That's a weird new system too, isn't it, Tori? That locking mechanism you just did? There's lots of new mechanics in this game. Okay, so there goes that ship, and we opened up the next face. Oh, go. He's got a flame something or other.
Watch yourself, BB-8.
How did you destroy the last force field? What did you do? Shit, I need to stay out of the fire. We already have true Jedi. Is there any point to me keeping... Oh, sorry. Where am I? Where are you? There you are. Chewbacca. Yeah, I'm not strong enough. Chewbacca can rip your arms out of their sockets. And that is it's a trap! What's his name? Admiral Akbar. It's a trap! Okay, that force field is pushing me back. That's a Chewbacca thing. Wait, where are you? Okay, you're back here. Oh, build. And this is... This is the first game in the series, I think, that is voiced, right? Or maybe the Clone Wars one was. We didn't watch the cartoon series of the Clone Wars, so we weren't familiar with the storylines. So it wasn't nearly as enjoyable as the ones we're familiar with, but we've both seen this new movie a bunch of times already, and we love it, so... So this is much more familiar and fun. But this is still just the first scene in the movie, basically.
I can't put the fire out. We've got to save Force Anteca. You can fix it, right? I'm no good with machines.
Fix that. Okay, we gotta fix the wires. It's trying to show us. Collect my Lego pieces. See, Victor says it looks good. He played the Lord of the Rings one. Tori and I played the Lord of the Rings one. We like that one a lot. But, he does build fast. Poe, is this Poe? Damashek? No. Damara. Damashek. Okay, can you pump it? On this? No. Am I supposed to pull it or something? You're making it glow. Am I supposed to make something drop? Let me jump on here. Can you do anything to it? Little robot? No? BB-8 makes really cute sounds. Do you think it plays well if one has not seen the movie? Victor, I assume you're talking about this game here that we're playing. The strange thing... Oh, I just killed it, Tori, and it busted up. Yeah. Okay. It's weird that there's the directional building. They give you different options of building stuff different places. There we go. And you're supposed to go And we still don't know what these question marks are about. That's a new thing too, a new mechanic to the game. Victor, have you not seen this new Star Wars movie? Do I think it plays well without having seen the movie? I don't quite know. I think all these Lego games in particular work a lot better if you are familiar with the story. Am I supposed to be pulling on something? My grappling hook's not locking on to anything. I'm supposed to blow something up. Here, let me blow this up and then build it somewhere else again. You sure? Oh, there was a third spot. There you go. Okay, now see what that thing is. Can you throw your little connector thing at it? Your little robo grappling hook? Oh, there you go. Nice. So I think it's a fun game. Like, Victor, I'm getting back to your point here. It's not, I don't think it's dependent upon the story to have a good time, but I think these LEGO games are way more fun if you're familiar with them. Like I was saying earlier, we did not enjoy the Clone Wars game because we didn't watch that cartoon series, so we didn't understand any of the storylines that we were doing. Not that the puzzles have anything to do with the content of the movie, but if you know the storyline, it does help you kind of know. It does give you maybe hints about what you're supposed to do. You probably have to move the tank back before you can use it. So what, do I have to deploy it again or something? Move the tank back where? Back to the original spot? Nothing. Where should I build it? This is getting ridiculous. These puzzles sometimes take so long to figure out what the hell they want you to do. Oh, yeah, and then you do your little directional thing, right? What are you supposed to do? Get the circle in the middle of the circle, right? There it goes. Okay, yeah. What did that do for us? I should blow this up and rebuild it somewhere else again? You think? Oh, you're controlling what direction it goes now. Over here? Yeah. Most characters do not build as fast as this guy does. That's impressive. And what did that do? Oh, can I jump? No, I cannot make that jump, I don't think. No, I'm not gonna be able to make that up. Where's Jar Jar Binks when you need him, right? Say what you will, everyone who hates Jar Jar Binks. But in the past games, best jumper in the game. You have a high spot you need to reach, go to Jar Jar. Ooh, I just saw a little circle face for... See it right there? For Captain Phasma or Phantasma or whatever her name is. And a little bit of a trivia about that character, Tori. Did you know that she is played by the same actress who plays Brienne of Tarth on Game of Thrones? Alright, I'm lost. Do you want me to rebuild this thing somewhere in particular? How about back over here on the top of that thing? Alright. Does that help anything? Now can you connect to it? Well, Moses is waking up again, everyone. Yay. Yeah, we might have to go be adults here pretty soon. Oh, there you go. Ah, perfect. These puzzles are so frustrating sometimes. Yeah. We should really put a headset on you. Does anyone in the chat room know that if I put another headset on Tori, if she will also be heard? Can two people be heard? Or is it just a one person at a time thing? Oh, do you see? He's got the green splotch on his...
Look how old you've become.
Oh, man.
Far worse has happened to you.
You know what I've come for.
I love his voice.
You get as far away from here as you can. Do you hear me?
They used the actual audio from the movie. That's the exact lines.
The map to Skywalker.
Yes, it is.
We know you found it.
You're
going to give it to the First
Order. The First Order rose from the dark side. You did not.
That guy's in Game of Thrones, too. Victor thinks that they'd be able to hear us both, so we should try that sometime. Tori, do you want to put a headset on? Yeah, baby's waking up, so we'll test this real quick, but we're going to have to sign off here in just a few minutes. He's got a plunger. You need to plug it into your controller right there. I think it only goes one way, doesn't it? Right there, that's Brienne of Tarth, that shiny stormtrooper. Took his plunger, man. In the movie, that's a bloody handprint on his helmet. In the game, it's a green splotch. Oh, perfect place to stop, too. We just finished the level. Right here, honey. There's a little... Should be... Nope. Here, honey. Over on the left a little bit. Is there not a hole there? You don't have a hole there. You have a... You're hilarious. I don't know. Weird. I was wondering what the difference was. I got this control for you. There's no audio jack in that one. Okay, well, can't even test it out anyway. Boom. Alright, well, jeez, look at all these characters we've unlocked. Stormtrooper. That's great. The only problem with all these new Star Wars movies is it's a whole nother, like, 40 characters you have to learn their names of and all that. I don't know. So, we just saved. We'll continue on Assault on Jakku. Oh, we just finished Assault on Jakku. We'll continue with the story. Maybe we'll broadcast again sometime. Thanks, everyone, for watching. We'll see you later. Bye-bye. Wasteland. See you in the wasteland, Tori says.